This summer's M2 MacBook Air is looking a lot like a Donna Summer, as in hot, hot, hot. We didn't expect to find active cooling in this base model M2 Air, but we didn't find much of a passive cooling system either. Not even a heat spreader, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Even without the slimming wedge, the flashy new M2 Air is not only thinner than its predecessor, but also manages to pack in more ports. The glorious return of MagSafe, 2 Thunderbolt 3 ports, and a headphone jack. It's also got a clever trick up its sleeve, or spine. Speaker grills. No more perforated top case, sound is pumped out between case and display. And while they're not the best speakers ever, Apple's obsession with sound still comes through. And they sound great. Speaking of speakers, Creative Electron gives us our first look at their new placement, and they look small. We also get a glimpse at the keyboard. Not super serviceable, but at least it's not as fragile as the butterfly keyboard era. It's been, 14 years since this joke was relevant, but the Air has come a long way, so let's open it up. Just 4 screws, but the same mildly terrifying tugging as the 14-inch MacBook, and the lower case is free. Where's the battery connector? Hopefully not under the logic board. Time to go digging under some brackets for some likely targets. Some frankly pint-sized screws and brackets later, hey, that's a neat trapdoor. Turns out the battery socket was right here all along, using a tiny iPhone-like connector. Battery safely disconnected, we start excavating the logic board. More brackets, more screws, some of them hidden, and yeah, a couple more fiddly bits, and the logic board is free. But it's not much to look at till we take the clip-on shield off. Underneath, we find a wealth of chips. Highlights include the soldered 64-bit octa-core M2 itself, including GPU, a single soldered 256GB NAND flash memory chip, a likely Apple-made Thunderbolt 3 driver, a USI chip that is likely just Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, and a little birdie also pointed out an accelerometer. If you've got any ideas why Apple might put one in their new laptop, let us know. We also find a lot of empty space. The empty pad makes sense. It's for the extra SSD chip we didn't pay for. But where's the heat spreader? What's this huge gap? And how does this thing cool down? Sure, it has a lot of thermal paste and graphite tape, and yeah, the M2 is efficient, but this shield is super thin, so it's not helping much. And the case is lighter than last year, so maybe the M2 Air is secretly an iPad? Or maybe Apple is just letting it run hot. Before my brain overheats, let's get to some hardware that makes sense. A few screws, some escape artist washers, and the trackpad is free. And I'm free from its annoying cable. I'm sure you want to hear about these four speakers, but it's going to take a lot of digging to get there. Some obvious screws, the ones that secure them to the case, and some that are buried under these annoying hinge covers. These help reinforce the hinge, which is a good thing, but wow, they are no fun to remove. While we're up here, let's grab that super thin audio board. It's adhered but comes right up. Even better, every single port, the endangered headphone jack, prodigal MagSafe charger, and both USB-C ports are modular and not glued down. We love to see it. Finally, the Touch ID button comes out through the top case with ease. On to the battery. With no markings, it's hard to tell, but this almost looks smaller than last year. The 4 cells are held into the case with a combination of a metal tray with repair-friendly screws and stretch-release adhesive. Not to brag, but I got every strip out intact. Granted, these are a very slick horseshoe shape, which means that if one tab breaks, the other tab will extract all the remaining adhesive. Stretch-release honestly can't be beat, except by these screws. Ah, reusable fasteners, my old friends. Like iPhones these days, the specs are on the back, giving us a rating of 52.6 watt-hours. And while it has 4 separate units, it operates the top 2 in parallel and the bottom 2 in series, making it technically a 3-cell battery. When it's all said and done, the Air still fits in a simple envelope. The Mac has been headed in a positive direction these days. More, better ports, a better keyboard, and a return to some repairable ideas. I don't know if I trust a fanless, heat-spreaderless, non-upgradable laptop, especially to base model spec. But at least the shadow of the Retina era seems to be passing. Plus, Apple says we'll get parts for this one. So check back in a few months. Maybe we'll do a repair together. Until then, keep on fixing.